started. He had done all the things that God had asked him, but I told you, he wasn't humble in his last days. He got a little arrogant. Where he got arrogant is that he didn't know his job. I'll say that one more time. Anybody in here unsure what their job is? Tell your neighbor, stay in your lane. Sometimes we do a job long enough, we feel like we can do everything. And what Uzziah did is he wanted to do the priest's job. And there was only certain jobs in the Old Testament that only the priests could do. But he thought, I've been serving the Lord a long time. I feel like I can do what the priests do. And as I said, God struck him down with leprosy. It was a painful disease. It was an ugly disease. It was a disease that when you went around, folks, you had to announce, I'm unclean. I'm unclean. It was a disease that when people had, they put you in isolation. So we had this great king of Israel who had followed God's word for so many years is now set up somewhere, maybe in an old folks home for old kings. I don't know. He's set up somewhere and he's by himself. Yeah, I just added it. You won't find that in the scripture. I just want to make sure you understand what I'm saying. Amen. Amen, you got it. Amen. So at the time, Isaiah was feeling pretty bad that the king was dying. That the king was dead. He, as I said earlier, he said, what am I going to do? How are we going to go on? And many of us today wonder about our future. We don't know what tomorrow holds. Some of us don't know what today holds. But as I said, you still must see the Lord. But I want to assure you, even in his time of sadness, there was something else that came along in the scripture. It says, in the day that King Uzziah died, I love the King James Version for this verse. It says, I also saw the Lord. I'll say that one more time. He said, in the day that King Uzziah died, my friend, someone who was a leader for Christ, I'm sad. I don't know what's going to happen. I'm distraught. Who's going to take over the kingdom? I also saw the Lord. Yeah. But it tells me that sometimes in the midst of our darkest situation, there's always going to be an also. If we look our eyes on the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, even though the earthly king had died, there was still the eternal Lord of Lords, the eternal King that was still going to be with him. Amen? Amen. So you have to be able to, something Reverend Fry used to say is, see beyond the turning of the road. Sometimes we're so focused on what's happening right now that we don't have enough faith to trust in God. Sometimes things have been going so well for us that we don't have enough faith to trust in God. Sometimes the money in your bank account has always been in the positive. And when it messes around to get in the negative, you start to hollering and crying and slinging snot because you don't know what you're going to do. Maybe you had 10 outfits to choose on Sunday, but now you're reduced to 2. You don't know what you're going to do. Your children start to act a fool, and you don't know where to go. But I'm asking you, in the time of your situation, in the time of your trouble, can you also see the Lord? I hate to say it, but sometimes in the church, the saints are too easy to give up. We see an obstacle, and then we forget about God. We think about how big it is. We think about how much it's going to cost. We think about how much trouble it's going to be for us to do it. And we stop taking, we take our eyes off of God, and we focus on the problem. And we say, there's no way that I can carry that weight. There's no way that I can pay that bill. There's no way that I can get out of that situation. There's no way my child is not going to end up in jail. There's no way that my child is not going to end up pregnant doing the things that we do. But if you turn your perspective and fix your lenses and keep your eyes on God, you'll be amazed of how small your problem will look if you look at it from a heavenly perspective. Amen? Amen. Do you believe that? So I want to leave you with 3 quick points. We can get up out of here. There's 3 quick points that when you do see the Lord. The first thing is when you see the Lord, you will see God in his proper place. Do you believe that? it says in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord. But not only did they see him, he said, I saw him sitting on a throne. But he wasn't just sitting, he was high and lifted up. He wasn't just sitting, he wasn't just high and lifted up, but his train, his robe filled the temple. Yes, what does that mean? So when you get into a right relationship with God, you will realize that you and God are not equals. You will realize that God is where he's always been. There's a book that I read last week. It says, where is God when trouble comes? God is in the same place where he has always been. I'll read it for you. I'll tell you where he's sitting on a throne. He's high and he's lifted up. And his train and his robe, it fills the temple. Listen, even though the earthly king had died, I already said, but the God of Israel lives. He lives today, hallelujah. And he's sitting in his proper place, high and lifted up. Even though Uzziah reigned over the people of Israel, I come to tell you, if you don't know the God that we serve, he reigns over the world. He reigns over the just and the unjust. And I'll tell you that he's still reigning today. Hallelujah. He reigns over our circumstances. He reigns over our problems. He reigns over our situation. He is still reigning. Hallelujah. But the second point is that you will see yourself in your proper place. Oh, I know y'all didn't like that. So after you see God in his proper place, you will see yourself in your proper place. Yes, deacon, minister, musicians, we got a place. And we need to be in our proper place. Let me tell you. Isaiah said, woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. I'll read it one more time. It says, woe is me, for I am undone. I am a man of unclean lips. And I dwell, I hang out with. I'm in the midst of some people with unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. What was happening right there in the scripture, in case you didn't believe me, Isaiah was being humbled. He got to realize how small and insignificant he was, and how magnificent the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He didn't get so high-minded that he'd been serving the Lord as long as he's been serving, so he's been right all his days. But he said, I'm a man of unclean lips. He was saying, I got some sins. I got some issues, and I hang around some people who got some sins. And we got some issues. So I just said that to say that if anybody in here walked in here thinking that they were perfect, I would hate to bust your bubble this morning, because we have all come short. We are all nothing but filthy rags in the sight of God. I know you may have a little bit more than I got. Well, God bless you, girl. Your suit may be a little bit sharper than my suit. God bless you. You may have a little bit of more money. You might have a lot more money than me. But you may have some situations in your life that we think that we're better than other people. We get on our high horses and we think we're better than the neighbor next door. We think we're better than the homeless person. We think